Hey, so we're going to replace the fender trim on this 2018 Toyota Tacoma. So let's get to it. So yeah, this video should be good for any 2016 and up Toyota Tacoma, Sport, Off-Road, or TRD Pro. As you can see, this one got a little scraped up, so we're going to remove this trim piece and replace it with a new one. So the first thing you got to do is remove these 10 millimeter screws. So there's one, two, three. There's two up behind here at the very top. There's one right here and one right there, and then there's one in front. So that's a total of six. So and once again, yeah, these are 10 millimeter. They have a Phillips head on them, so you can try using a Phillips head screwdriver, but as well, this works a lot better. Okay, and then like I said, there's two more, kind of a funny angle. And then that last one. Got it. And then actually, on some trucks, you will see down below, behind the wheel, there'll be one more of those screws, but this one doesn't have it. You should be able to pop this whole thing off. And what I'm gonna do is actually use these yellow scrapers to kinda get in between there. Let's see if I can do this. And these things aren't gonna, these aren't going to scrape up the body so much. So, but they will help. Kind of get rid of, kind of slice through that tape a little bit there. Because there is kind of a foam double stick tape, which is something you're going to want to buy. There's a 3M version of it that I'll link below that you can use. It's perfect for this. But yeah, using this, you know, this edge is like just sharp enough that it'll slice through this tape, but it won't really scrape your paint. Kind of good to do this rather than pull it off, because if you pull on it, this tape is actually pretty sticky, and so there's a chance that it could actually pull some of the paint off. All right, so see, so after that, there should just be some clips. There you go. And that's what it looks like. So you can see it's held on the front by, well, this part kind of broke off. But if you look at the clips here, so that popped in. Here's the one that broke that will look just like this, but it broke off. It's right there, held on with these blue and orange clips that also twist in and out. And some of them break when you take this off. And I think the idea is you wanna twist them and they come out. So. These are available on Amazon as a package. They're also available from the dealer for like a dollar or so, maybe $2 each. So, but you can get the whole package of enough for the whole truck on Amazon. So let's see. Come on.
There you go. Okay. Oh, that one came out just fine. So before I replace all those, I'm just going to kind of clean this up a little bit here, get all the dirt off of it, even though you can't see it. It just makes you feel better knowing that it's clean underneath there. So I was just using some of this Griot's Garage Speed Shine, and I was just spraying it on there, just and then wiping it down with a microfiber towel that I got right here. Okay, so the last thing is I just want to take off all of this extra old tape goo. So the best thing that I found that I have is this Goo Gone citrus adhesive remover. And so I was just kind of wiping it on there with a rag, you know, got something on a rag. And, you know, it's not the best process, but if you kind of soak it on there, you know, it'll kind of dry out the adhesive a little bit. And then I was just using my thumbnail to kind of pull it off, and then you can almost get a little ball of it kind of going, and it almost starts to take itself off. Like it sticks to itself. So I don't know, I'm sure there's a better way of doing this, but it's working. Cleaned everything up. Took out the broken tab there. So here is the pack of clips that you can buy off of Amazon. And pack 38. You get the blue ones and the orange ones. And they're pretty much identical, except they actually seem to have one kind of nice little improvement here. Right here. Here, this is the old one that I took off the truck. And here's the one that comes in this pack of clips, and it actually has this little foam backing. Okay, so they didn't want to go on with the foam backing, so I just took the foam backing off of these two. It just seems that little bit of extra thickness just wasn't allowing it to clip into the holes. But I got those two in, and you kind of have to, if you didn't pay attention to exactly how these were all oriented, when you took them off, like I didn't. The way these fit, you could see there's two kind of like outer wings here, and that's not gonna let it fit this way. It has to turn this way. So if you look at the flare, that means that this has to be oriented with the two clip tabs facing up and towards the top and bottom and not to side. So that means it had to go in like that, as opposed to like that. Okay, so I got all the new clips in there. And the way it goes, starting at the front here, you get a blue, orange, blue, 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 orange in the corner, blue, blue, and then orange at the bottom. The way the clips are kind of oriented, this one's kind of up and down, up and down, and then they just kind of follow almost the curve of this. Okay, there's the new flare piece straight from the Toyota dealership. Let's see if we can find that number. This is for the right front, obviously. And the only ones that are available now are the ones that are, you know, this kind of matte finish. I guess there's part numbers for another version that did exist that had a primered finish as it comes out of the box. And that was for the Tacoma Sports. But those aren't actually available from the Toyota dealership. So, ta-da! All right. There it is. Nice new piece. Okay, so what we gotta do is prep this by just kind of wiping it down with a little bit of rubbing alcohol where we're gonna place the tape, which is just along this edge right here. And the tape we're using is this 3M number 38583, and this is a
double-sided, very sticky, kind of a foam, gray foam tape. And it's pretty much exactly what was on there. Let's see. Okay, I decided to use the packaging as kind of like a bed to put this on, just so I don't scratch the exterior side of this flare before I even put it on. But anyway, so this edge isn't really so much of, it's not really an edge, it's a series of like rails or lips there. But the idea is that there could still be some oils that are on there just from manufacturing, so we're going to try to get that off to make sure that the tape adheres as well as possible. And I can't really put the tape on while holding the camera, so I'll get back to you. Okay, so I got the tape on there. I started at this end, just kind of held it out and pressed it in, like maybe a couple inches at a time. Just being very careful to just stay on the edge, but not let the tape overlap the edge, because if you let it overlap outside of the flare, then you're just gonna see it. So I try to keep it just on the inside. Alright, protective strip is off, and now I'm gonna have to line this up and pop it on. I think the easiest thing to do here would be to line up these first two built-in clips at the front. I'm just gonna go ahead and pop that in. And then I think what I'm gonna do is come over to the other end and try to pop that last orange one in there. Okay, so I pressed it all in, and I made sure to press on the edge here to make sure that tape is making a good seal between the flare and the fender, and it looks pretty good. And all those clips went in actually really easily. It looks like I got a little tiny bit of that tape showing through right here, which annoys me a little bit, to be honest. So now all I have to do is put the six 10 millimeter screws back in. Just snug them up. You don't want to go too tight here, because it is just screwing into plastic. So if you go too tight, you're just going to strip it out. So just until it's snug there. Just until it's snug. Don't push it. And then there's these two underneath. Put all the screws in place, and finger tightened them. Just tighten them. And the last one. Oop. Just tight. Okay. Okay, let's give it a little final wipe down here. Get all the fingerprints off of it. Brand new fender flare for the Tacoma TRD Pro. It's actually really easy. Really, really easy.